What's good? You welcome back. Hope everybody's doing okay, staying safe, not catching the Rona, staying healthy. I just want to be quick with this one. I just want to say thank you everybody for joining the live stream today for the zombies reveal. We didn't get a trailer yet. We did get a teaser though, as you guys see on the screen and the beginning of this video. We also hit a record high of 81 viewers today. So I appreciate that. That's pretty much my highest ever of all time. I was so hyped. I'm so glad. So thank you everybody for tuning in. I will be live again on Wednesday for the official Call of Duty Zombies gameplay trailer. So make sure you guys tune in. It's probably just going to be a regular trailer, but I'm still going to go live. Make sure I react to it, watch it with you guys and talk to you guys or whatever, you know, however they reveal it. So thank you guys once again for tuning into the stream today. We didn't get much from this teaser video that we unlocked today. All we really got was, you know, just some gruesome zombie images. There's not too much to take from this video. We could see PPSH submachine guns in this video. I'm pretty sure what it is is PPSH. So that's all we really got. We got some old school World War II-ish Cold War soldiers in uniforms, you know, just getting bodied over here by zombies. So it's probably gonna be the launch map that we get when the game drops. The map that we've been seeing in all these teasers, and I'm pretty sure it's all the same map. But yeah, so not too much to take from that. Now, right after we got that teaser trailer, or that teaser video, basically, Treyarch and Call of Duty had tweeted out this, small little promotional image, video, whatever you call it. It has no sound, but it shows basically the Black Ops Cold War Zombies logo with half of a soldier, half of a zombie. And if you happen to be able to watch this in full, highest quality, you can see to the top left of the soldier, the Juggernaut logo. Really hard to see, but it's in the back. You can see the Juggernaut logo. Now in this video I really can't see it, so I'm gonna actually show that, just the still image, and then kind of show you guys on screen right here. You can clearly see the Juggernaut logo, which gives another indication of Ether, another confirmation of Juggernaut coming, which is pretty much the only perk we got right now for zombies. But you know, Juggernaut is the best perk of all time, hands down. I don't care what anybody said. And we also see this Omega symbol right here. There's something interesting about the Omega thing. We don't really know what it means, but a lot of references to it. And funny enough, the last Nuketown Zombies remake was basically called Alpha Omega. So really curious to see where the storyline goes and what this Omega thing really is. But yeah, we're gonna see a full trailer on Wednesday the 30th, so make sure you tune in if you want to see it here and react with me and see what we get for zombies. But in other news, they also dropped the season 6 gameplay trailer for Warzone and Modern Warfare, and there's a lot we can take from this trailer. There's gonna be huge changes to Warzone. I'm pretty hyped. It's gonna get me back into it. I don't play it every single day because it kind of gets stale, but this is hype. We've seen a lot of these leaks basically coming for a long time. So what we can see on the screen in this first shot is a subway train pulling in, which we already knew that was coming if you paid attention to the leaks. It's basically gonna change the entire flow of Warzone. There's gonna be subways through the bottom under the map, basically subway trains running back and forth to different parts of the map. So it's gonna be pretty much a fast travel, a new area to fight while traveling across the map. So you're definitely going to be able to get around the map without having to worry about people camping on buildings and getting sniped from afar, or people camping in weird spots. You can get from point A to point B and really only have to fight underground in close quarters. So that's going to be dope. I can't wait. I'm really hyped for that to basically change the flow of the map. In this next shot, we see these heavily armored trucks driving around with turrets on top. I'm really interested to see how those play out. Maybe those trucks are stronger because of the armor on there. It's going to be basically indestructible or harder to, you know, destroy. And I'm sure those turrets are probably going to be OP. I'm not sure, but it's definitely going to be a new aspect to the game and a new way to play and get kills and basically drive around and shoot stuff up in Warzone. So interesting. It might be annoying, it might be cool, but I'm definitely interested to see how those play out as well. Now this next shot is what really blows my mind. Okay, so I seen on Twitter right after this trailer dropped that this map, this cyber attack map, Tank Factory, basically half a year ago or in the beginning of the summer, before we even knew the next COD that was coming out, we saw some leaked pre-alpha footage, quote unquote, of Black Ops Cold War, and there was clearly the MP5, clearly the red dot reflex type that we've seen in Cold War and alpha gameplay, and clearly the Treyarch HUD and movement system and mechanics, and basically it was clearly the Treyarch game that we saw in the leaked footage, and it took place on a Tank Factory map. Now I don't know if this is the exact same map, we're gonna have to see once we play it, but it basically looks identical, and we didn't see or hear anything about that tank map in the alpha or the beta or anything, any of the information of Cold War, other than that leaked footage that we saw. So I don't know if this, they just gave it to Infinity War. I don't know if that was, I really don't know what that footage was, or if this is even the same exact map, but that was supposedly gonna be a map coming into Cold War. And it was supposed to take place in a tank factory, and it really, really, really looks similar. So I don't know. We're gonna have to wait and see. Once we actually play the map. In this next map, we see a map called Broadcast, which probably takes place in a news station or somewhere where they basically film news or sports or whatever. We don't get too much footage of it, but it basically, I guess they're trying to add a little more color to Modern Warfare. But this multiplayer map pretty much looks like the same, I ain't gonna lie, it looks like the same type of offices and reskins that they've been throwing around the entire game, but hey, maybe it flows right, we'll see how it plays out. And so these last two shots, we have one that is station, which is pretty much the train station in Verdansk and Verdansk Riverside, so I'm pretty sure they're just bringing pieces of Verdansk to multiplayer for ground war and bigger maps and, you know, bigger 12v12 or whatever the big TDM and domination game modes are with the bigger teams. So you know, I guess if you're excited for those game modes, enjoy. I personally don't play those, I like smaller maps, I like fast play, and I don't have time to be playing those really. Now in this last shot, it's obvious what's gonna happen here. It's gonna be some type of event starting October 20th, maybe leading up to Halloween, the haunting begins. It's obvious the map is going to turn into nighttime, which is going to be dope. We don't have any other details yet of that, but it is going to be a nighttime for sure. So I'm excited for that. We've been waiting for a nighttime version of Warzone. It's going to be lit. It doesn't look too dark, but who knows? Once we play it, there might be a lot of darker corners and darker rooms and stuff like that. Definitely going to change the flow again of Warzone. You're going to see sniper scopes all over the place. You're going to see a bunch of crazy stuff. So it's going to be lit. It's going to add a whole new factor and playstyle to Warzone. I'm excited for Season 6. It's giving me a whole nother reason to play the game. It's been getting stale, but, you know, with each season, it's kind of like we get another boost to keep going. So October is going to be lit. We also get the beta this month. It's going to be lit. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. That's all pretty much. If you guys are excited for Season 6, drop a like. If you guys are excited for zombies, drop a like. Drop a comment down below. Tell me what your thoughts are, what you're most excited for. Let me know if you're excited for these new map changes and these new additions to Warzone. Thank you guys once again for tuning into the stream today. Make sure you pop in Wednesday. Blow it up again like that. I want to hit 100 next time. So yeah, make sure you guys share this video. Subscribe. Turn on post notifications. Hit that bell. Hit me up on Twitter. Make sure you follow me on Twitter. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you on the next video. Be easy.